Good day, liberators. I hope that this is the very last time I'm going to discuss the subject of emancipation. Now, what is emancipation? Should you, should you not? To emancipate or not to emancipate? That is the question. Now, those of you who are following me know that I am not a big supporter of the current emancipation processes going on in South Africa. And there are very valid reasons that I've mentioned over and over again. And unfortunately, there are so many people who, in the way presented in most instances in South Africa, many people have fallen victim to this pure scam run by certain of these organizations. And I'm going to mention one specifically, UR Law. Now, UR Law is run by a lady by the name of Anne Verster. I've mentioned her and the organization before. She's of middle age, roughly about maybe a bit older than I am. Her organization is basically influenced and financed by a man by the name of Rudolf Buurman, an 80-year-old emancipator activist, and also Johan Ruud. Many of you have heard about Johan Ruud. And I've indicated that Johan Ruud is definitely an agent of banks. And then there's another guy by the name of Zane Lawrence. Zane Lawrence has opened multiple of social media sites. He's running plenty of them, promoting emancipation, common law, bill of exchange, etc., etc. And so people believe that he has got a footing, a major influential footing. But I tend to say that I believe that he might be in the same category as people like Skalk van der Merwe and Louis Liebenberg, who have blown up their support tremendously, utilizing internet sites where you can purchase followers and participants in your social media platforms to appear as if you've got plenty of followers. But as I have also identified these people are doing, they also have other numbers, and where you think that they are engaging with other people, it's actually themselves with other aliases that they're using on social media. So it appears as if there's a big following of them, and then at the end of the day it's simply themselves and the other support they've actually purchased from some Indian or Chinese website. Go and Google it, it's out there. How can I purchase more followers on social media? Go and DuckDuckGo that, and you will quickly see that there are plenty of those platforms where you can do that. And but leave it as by, the problem that I have and why I'm saying that UR Law in particular is running a scam. If you for 1 minute think that by just simply by sending notices to the post office and to the Chief Justice and to the United Nations and to the all around, and suddenly your debt will just disappear, you are very much gullible or desperate. Let me rather use the way this or the word phrase desperate, because what these emancipators do is that they make you believe you are in dire straits, you are in financial ruins, and you don't know how to get out of it. And if there is someone who can say, oh, but your debt, your 2 million rand debt to this XYZ bank will suddenly disappear if you follow this emancipation process, obviously you will get excited and see, oh, well, there's proof, and they've got thousands of followers, many people, and like there are many people talking about it on social media, even if it's only themselves. To encourage this, this must work, because many people said that, oh, I have all my debt have disappeared and blah, 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 blah. Now, the problem is that, the first hurdle that they must always overcome, and that is the point where I'm either deleted from social media platforms, or that is when behind my back I am being derogatory posts are posted against myself and Liberty Fighters Network and my assistants, Herman, and also Advocate Jennings, etc., to say that we are con artists and we are actually bank agents and blah, blah, blah. But every time when I say, okay, but people, if you hear this, all these allegations against me and Liberty Fighters Network. Please, I invite you, and it's in public interest that you decide which platform you're going to invite me on. And live in front of all the public, you present your proof that we are bank agents. And come and debate why I don't believe in emancipation in the way that they are. So let them debate that their principles are working. And people can make an informed decision at the end of the day, a balanced information that's presented. But unfortunately, at this point in time, emancipators only use the one-sided, the pro-emancipation, but they do not tell you about the cons, the negative parts of emancipation. The first one, and that is the point where I'm ridiculed, is how, when you are emancipated, how do you enforce your emancipation? So that is the point where they totally start to do beating around the bush and they don't know what to answer, or they change the subject. But how are you going to enforce your emancipation? So if the sheriff suddenly pitches up at your home or on your farm, because farmers are being targeted, our producers of our food are being targeted by these emancipators. Now, when the sheriff suddenly pitch up at your farm and say, we attaching this, it's going to go on auction, and it's a family farm, several generations. And you just say, but well, I've been emancipated. Here's my proof. I've sent it to Pete Pompey's and overseas, to Donald Trump and to whoever. And I have the proof that I have been emancipated. I'm not part of the system anymore that you serve. Then he says, well, it's good, but because I am serving the system, which you apparently have dissected you yourself from, I'm serving this side, so I'm following the rules on this side, in the system side. So until you have not obtained a court order from this side to confirm that you have been emancipated and that this entire legal process was not valid against you, I unfortunately have to serve my system. So that is the point when your farm goes on auction, and you will most probably going to lose it at the end of the day. Those that we are working on, Liberty Fighters Network, who have come to our to us to assist them now, because emancipation did not work for them. Unfortunately, we have to do risk management each and every time they on them, and until we can get it to a point whereby we can just rescind the order. But there's no enforcement. You cannot go to, where's your police? Where is your army? So until you have not obtained, as a sovereign, breathing human being, establish your own army and police force, there's no one who's going to come to your rescue to enforce your rights. And to establish a judicial authority, a common law authority on your side, if the system's participants have not subscribed to your judicial authority, it's not enforceable. It's a court for your common law virtual reality. That is where you are currently operating. It's only valid in a virtual space. It's not in reality that you can enforce your rights. Yes, I would love it to happen. I would love to tell people that, yes, follow emancipation. Then you dissect yourself from this evil system and you're out of here. You're a free man, living, breathing. I would love that. But unfortunately, if you have been born in this system, you cannot choose that at one stage you suddenly dissect yourself from the system and move over to the other side of the wall. Because when it comes to the enforcement, when you say, okay, sheriff, get out of my, away from me. You don't have jurisdiction in my space, in my jurisdiction. You don't have jurisdiction. You will just come back with the police if the police is not there yet. And if you still don't want to cooperate, then the police of this system is going to arrest you in your sovereign system, because that is what they're going to do. You cannot say, okay, because I am emancipated, there's a wall now between, I can attack the system on this side, but this system, there's a false wall that all the spears that the system is going to throw to my side is just going to evaporate when it hits the force field, and I'm totally dissected. Wouldn't it be lovely to do that? But you cannot enforce it. The moment when you create your own police force and army, it's high treason. This system that believes that you are still part of it will see it as terrorism, as high treason, and you're going to be arrested and most probably stay a very long time in jail in the system that you hate and which you believe you have dissected yourself from. So unfortunately, that does not work. Then the second problem is that why would, if you have dissected yourself, emancipated, why would you utilize legislation like the Constitution of South Africa and human rights charters like the Nuremberg trials and a United Nations Bill of Charter of Rights and African Union, whatever, to enforce your rights or to say that your rights exist? Shouldn't you then stop using that legislation? Why would you want to think that while you're a common lawyer, you can make use of their acts and their legislation on this side, but when they throw their spears, it cannot reach your side? You either emancipated, you dissect yourself entirely from the entire system, or you must be unfortunately be part of the system. And that is where we are actually coming in. We are saying that we would love to be emancipated, but we are not there yet. It's very long still. We are using their own system against themselves. We are chiseling away. We are staying in this system, this evil system we don't want to be in, but we are chiseling away every day on this wall until it collapses and it's destroyed and demolished, and then we can build a new system. That is how we operate. That is our way of doing things from the Liberty Fighters Network side. So, but you cannot choose their rules, their legislation to confirm your right that you have in a system dissected from them. Cannot happen. It's not logic that if you dissect, if you choose to emancipate, you must emancipate and dissect yourself entirely from that system. That is the only way in which you can get emancipated, is to stop using the system in place that you hate so much. Stop using it. There's no letter that you have to send. There's no notice. There's no meeting that you have to have with the United Nations or with the President of the Republic of South Africa. You simply decide to dissect yourself from it. It's an immediate decision that you are making. It's not a process that you have to follow by the letter. It's just a decision, a willful decision to say, I'm not part of this anymore. But the moment when you move to your home in the Drakensberg and you have started to get your own, produce your own food, you've got your own water source, you've got your own electricity, you've got your own roads on the farm, stay there. Do not come back to the other side. Stay there. That is your world that you have then created for yourself, and you are then emancipated, you are set free. But unfortunately, up till that point, whereby you still have to go back to town from time to time to get groceries and maybe to get petrol. And the moment when you set your foot or your wheels, your tires on the tarmac of the system you have abandoned, you become part of that system again. So you cannot just say, okay, I'm emancipated, but I'm using their tar and their roads, and I don't have to follow the rules of the road in that system that I hate. And you start to drive in the middle of the road, on the wrong side of the road or whatever, and then you pulled over by a traffic officer, and then you say, oh, sorry, I'm emancipated, you cannot write a ticket to me, you cannot confiscate my car, you cannot do this, you cannot do that. Unfortunately, you are then screwed. You have to adhere to that, and you have, unfortunately, in the system, have failed to adhere to their rules and their legislation. So until you cannot be on that point where you have dissected yourself entirely from the evil system you want to get out of, emancipation cannot happen. Every time when you interact again, if you have, for example, you are law, they charge people in currency 30,000 rand or so to emancipate them. And people take their last money. They sell their last car that they've got, or their assets, because if they pay 30,000 rand to you or law and Anfester, then they don't have any debt, and what they're saving, it's going to be a benefit for them. The moment when they don't realize that But if you are law, doesn't want to be part of the system, why are they asking currency? 30,000 rand. Okay. And I must give them the currency itself. I cannot go and put 10 kilograms of feather in front of them because they're not accepting that as a payment. I cannot go and get a truck full of sand from the beach and dump it on Dolph Buurman's front yard and say, okay, but this is my payment, a truck full of sand. They will not accept it. They will say, no, you must pay the 30,000, otherwise we're not going to assist you. And even after you have been assisted by them, they jump back into the system once again, which they say they are promoting not to be part of. Then they tell you, oh, but you have obtained a benefit on that side, and now that your debt has been absolved, you need to pay us 2.4 million rand of the benefit, half of the benefit that you have benefited. So you cannot go to Ed Verster and Johan Root and to Zane Lawrence and tell them, okay, but here is a mountain full of rocks. All the rocks there is my payment to your 2.4 million rand that you want me to transfer into your names or into your bank account, which is run in the system. Technically speaking, people, when you engage in this emancipation system, you need to stop using the internet and email and your phone, your cell phone. You have to stop using that because by using that, you confirm that you are part of that system that you want to dissect yourself from. So you have to resort to smoke signals and to light lights, take a mirror and send light flashes to the other side to send your message. Or you must take a pigeon, a post pigeon, and take a letter and fix it to the foot of this little pigeon and say fly. That is how you need to operate. Because engaging in that system on their own version, where they tell you that do not engage in the court system that you are being sued in. Tell them that you are a free sovereign person, you have transferred your debt to this trust that you've created, and now the directors of the bank and even the judge of you have granted the original judgment is now the trustees of that trust. They tell you not to engage. But what is actually happening, people? Is it that the bank suddenly said, okay, absolved, we're going to write off your debt? When they write off your debt, it's not that merely transferring your outstanding balance to a suspense account. Secondly, yes, we know the story about securitization and everything, and we are trying to fight that in our cases, but we must never use the word securitization because at the moment when we use it, it's like a swear word that you must never mention in the court proceeding. You must always use the legal terms of that. But in any case, so what is actually happening is that because you have not, you have participated, you have filed your papers, sovereign papers, emancipation documentation in a court process. And that court process is not a legitimate court process considered in that system itself. It's just being ignored. It's as if you have never opposed it, as if your version is never before court. And then they continue in your absence. And in terms of the rules and the practices of the court, they don't have to communicate with you or notify you of any process further. Besides the fact when the sheriff pops up at your property and say, this has been attached and it's going to go on auction. Then by that time, in most instances, it's too late to do anything about it. So what your law is doing is that they are convincing you not to participate and defend yourself in a court system, in the court process where you have originally contracted in. You cannot say that, well, I've entered into an agreement with a bank and now I've decided to be sovereign, to be emancipated, and now I'm not adhering to that contract anymore. You have entered into that contract in that system. You must comply with that. You must use the system to get legitimately out of that contract. You cannot just go over and say that I've used the common law emancipation and I am debt free. Unfortunately, it does not happen. You can attack the bank. We are saying that all debt owed to a bank can be dismissed. But we are using their own system to challenge them. We are using their own procedures and legislation created inside the system to attack them, combined with numerous of common law principles, which the legislation does not specifically recognizing legislation, but you can use common law principles. And if it's confirmed that those principles do exist, then you can utilize it inside your own system to fight it. So you do not have to be emancipated in order to use common law. You can use common law principles immediately, directly attacking them from their own system. And as I've said, chiseling down this wall in order to let it collapse so that a new system can be built at the end of the day. People, bills of exchange. What a wonderful, there's actually legislation. But in terms of bills of exchange, the moment when you start using, you emancipated and you want to use a bill of exchange to pay for a debt, why pay for a debt of the bank if using their own system to fight that debt can resolve in you not actually owing that debt? Why do you have to agree that you owe them? That is what is happening. The moment when you send a bill of exchange to them for in the way that it's prescribed, they are telling you that it's a legitimate payment to the bank, and that once they accept it, your debt is then paid by the bill of exchange, and then suddenly it doesn't work like that. It's up to the one receiving the bill of exchange to actually confirm that they have abide by. They must physically accept the bill of exchange as a way of payment. You cannot just simply on, oh, by estoppel. Estoppel means that they by their actions, they have received it, but by their actions, they have agreed to this bill of exchange being submitted. If it hasn't gone off your account and showed that it has gone off, then it has not gone off. Then you still have that debt, but you can fight it legitimately in their own system so that you don't owe that debt. But you cannot admit by way of preemption, that is the word phrase used in law, preempting. So if someone have accused you of paying this and you have to pay this, and you suddenly make arrangements by a bill of exchange and you are paying your debt and there's no debt anymore, you have agreed to that. You have admitted that you owe that money. You are basically again screwed. The emancipation is telling you lies in the way that it's promoted by organizations like UR Law and Zane Lawrence and Johan Root and whoever. It's not working like that. Unfortunately, when an invader invades a country, so when the USA invaded Iraq and Afghanistan and so forth, they don't care about the rights of the citizens there. They don't care whether the legislation is saying that they cannot do that or this or that. They don't care about it. This is exactly what our enemies are doing, which are operating in the system. If they don't want to accept your sovereignty and they don't want to accept your rights, human rights, then it's up to them, because they control the army, they control the police. They instruct the police and the army to enforce their system against you. But unfortunately, you cannot do that unless a court inside the system has ruled that you are emancipated, you do not owe that money anymore, you are an independent human being breathing, until a court inside the system has made an order to which you can then take inside the system to say that your court has confirmed that I am emancipated, that I do not owe that anymore. Until you can't take that order, such an order, to the police and to the army and to whoever to enforce it, you do not have a chance. So, yes, there is this movement. And oh, then the last thing, and I hope I never ever talk about this. The other wonderful, valid argument is South Africa is registered as a corporation in the United States of America. I've done many videos about this, and people, go and Google it yourself. The Security and Exchanges Commission in the United States of America is not the institution to register corporations and business entities. Each state in the United States of America has its own corporation registration office and procedures to follow to make them corporations or partnerships or whatever the case may be. the Security Exchanges Commission. If South Africa is not registered as a corporation in the United States of America at the office of the Security Exchanges Commission, it's registered to do business in the United States of America on the exchanges and on with currencies and so forth, just like other countries as well. So the reference number of the Security Exchanges Commission is not a registration number for the corporation of South Africa. It's a reference number that South Africa may do business in America, USA, just like China, Russia, you name all the other countries who are also registered as doing business with security exchanges in the US of A. So unfortunately, I need to bring someone like Fayez Kristen, very nice person, but I've debated this with him before on WhatsApp. Now, I've told him, please let us just have a debate one-to-one live about this issue of corporation, because he is the one that, because he is such a nice person, and I truly think that he's a bright person and he's entitled to his beliefs. But if those beliefs are wrong, to advocate that unfortunately, that he believes that is the proof that South Africa is registered as a corporation in the United States of America. No, go and do your research properly, people. A reference number, it's registered as if it was a corporation, but it's registered as a government, etc. And that is not the proof that it is registered as a corporation in the USA, because the SEC is not the office to register corporations, to create an entity of a corporation, South Africa. That's not the office to do that. It's merely to state that South Africa, as some entity, and this is an entity of state, the government, may do business in our country. That's all it says. Please do not come up with the crap that South Africa is registered as a corporation with the SEC in America. Again, I was hoping that this issue about the corporation, and that is unfortunately used as a very very important mechanism to tell people who are following emancipation processes to commit to it, because there is the proof that South Africa is a corporation. And while it's not, it's a wild goose chase, people. And now because you're a corporation, you need to use maritime law that you are considered to be a corpse, and your names are written in capitalized letters on your grave and on your ID document. It's got nothing to do with the fact that South Africa is a corporation, because it's not. Hopefully this time around, this will open people's eyes. And I can't imagine, with all these red lights popping up left, right, and center throughout this entire process of emancipation, that those who have followed those processes have actually believed in that it's true. How can you, with all these red lights popping up, still believe that it's a legitimate process and even get angry when people tell you that it's not working in the way that you have been taught? Because you've seen the proof that South Africa has got a reference number and is a corporation in the United States of America. You've seen it, but it's not analyzed in context. You have not gone out and done your homework properly. And as I always say, people, listen to your sixth sense. You know, when I'm driving on the road and I want to turn right, and there's a car coming from the front, when I see that it's far away and there's no hesitation whatsoever and I turn, it's fine. But the moment, my philosophy is, my approach is that the moment when I am hesitant, must I not? That is, my answer is no. I will not turn because there's a doubt. So I'll rather sit and wait for the cars to come on, and then when I'm satisfied now, there's no hesitance, I can turn, I will do that. The same in life. When there's something not right, your answer must be no. No, don't do it. Don't accept it. But if you really want to accept emancipation as a way of getting out of the system, go and do your research. Go and ask people questions. And the first one you have to, how do you enforce it? When I am in need, will the police of South Africa come to assist me, or the Navy, or the Air Force? Will they come and bomb the sheriff that's on my property who wants to confiscate my property? Will it be enforced? Listen to what they've got to say. And if it sounds okay, but they're also not sure which they would. For example, there was this one guy, very much, a very nice guy as well. But he's got this dual authority and he's a judge in the system. And he, at one stage, there was an order that was made that Cyril Ramaphosa must be arrested. Oh, my word. Take that authority or that order of the authority obtained in the common law system and take it to Cyril Ramaphosa and tell him that you have violated our rights, blah, blah, and you are now being arrested. I don't think that you will be alive shortly thereafter, because I think his bodyguards would definitely sort you out and assume that you are a terrorist or a threat to our or the president inside the system. They will come to the rescue of the president, who is supposed to be the so-called evil one against whom a jural order was granted, but unfortunately that means absolutely nothing to them enforcing it inside the system. Can you create your own court or tribunal? Oh yes, you can. Within the system, you are authorized to create common law courts or tribunals. It's regulated either by way of the Arbitration Act or simply by common law, and you can create your own common law court. Anyone can create it, but you have to physically subscribe. There must be proof that you have committed yourself to the authority of that tribunal. And at the end of the day, even if you have followed the tribunal processes and the order is made against you, it cannot be. How is it going to be enforced without using the system? So that is why if you use it inside the system, you can go to the court to make it an order of the court, and then that order of the court is then enforced on your on the others. That is how it operates. So yes, you can be a judge in your own tribunal. You can be a judge jury. But at the end of the day, you have to subscribe. What they don't tell you in judge jury is that they are physically subscribed to be part of that or under that authority of that tribunal created by Judge Judy. So her order is then basically enforced. It cannot be taken on appeal, and it's enforced by eventually, if the person doesn't on his own will go and make that payment to you, then you have to go to the High Court in South Africa and make it an order of the High Court, and then it can be enforced. So that's the only way in which that. So it's possible, but it can still only be enforced by way of an order of the court. So there's, people, no court in South Africa up till today have issued an order confirming that anyone has followed the correct emancipation process. We have, in fact, from the Liberty Fighters Network side, indicated that we will take the right and the correct order at the end of the day to enforce it, to obtain a court order confirming that a certain person has been emancipated. But that is a process we have to follow inside the system. You cannot do that from standing outside the system. There's apparently this court case during this week, and everyone is asked to please participate in this, come and support us in Joburg. This is for our sovereignty and whatever the case may be, and for the bill of exchanges to be confirmed. I'm very much worried about that case. I'm worried that that case might be used when it will most surely be a drop-dead case on arrival. Sorry to say it, but that would then be used as a precedent against all those who are trying to fight this system legitimately like ourselves. We have to constantly fight adverse judgments in other cases, in our cases we are pursuing. This is exactly what has happened with the Sapra case. There was this case way back in 2009 in the Supreme Court of Appeal that have cut my throat in the High Court. And unfortunately, I have to now attack that court order in the Supreme Court of Appeal to have a legitimate order or to for our case to succeed. So, unfortunately, precedence, if a court has already judged a certain aspect, it's used as a precedent in other cases as well. And if that precedent has been set on a totally incompetent grounds, like I believe is going to happen in this matter in this week in Johannesburg as well, it's going to be kicked to the sideline. It's not going to come out in the way that we want it to be. Something similar has been attempted a few years ago by a Khoi San tribe or movement in the Cape, and basically the judge have just kicked it to the sideline. And I'm worried that because they are not fighting. If they were fighting it from within the system and utilize the full system with the common law and everything to fight this, they would have been or will be successful at the end of the day. But if you are saying that you are sovereign and emancipated and you're standing on that side of the fence and trying to enforce something that you have obtained in this side, you don't have the way and the ammunition to fight this properly. You only have your common law principles, and unfortunately at this point in time, it's very much a dead case from the beginning if you only have that to assist you. People, hopefully this have put a lid on the question about emancipation, and I challenge any emancipator out there, please challenge me to a debate live to discuss this. You come up with your proven arguments, I come up with my proven argument, and together the people can make an informed decision. But please do not tell them that if they follow this, they will be emancipated and they don't have to pay a cent to the banks. Unfortunately, if you have contracted in this system you do not like, you must fight it in this system you do not like. You cannot jump to another country or other virtual reality and say that you are now standing on that side, you cannot touch that. Unless you can take your soil, your home, and put it in with you in the virtual reality, and it disappears in the current system, it's no longer there, you've hidden it, it's a when they go to your farmhouse and they can't see it, and there's some sort of cloak making it disappear, and there's nothing there, then yeah, by all means. But until you can do that, please do not fall for emancipation scams, and they are scams at this point in time. There's no other word for it. God bless. Until the next time.
Liberty Fighters Network.
Liberty Fighters Network.